Spartans Rockets. For the first time since 1978, the host city has two of its own in the state Class A championship game. And it's as simple as that. Take state. It's the battle cry of every high school in this state. And for Lincoln Northeast, they've taken state 2 years in a row. Can they make it three? We'll find out. Now let's meet the starters and the reserves for the Rockets and the Spartans.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the Nebraska School Activities Association and its member schools, welcome to the Bob Devaney Sports Center for the NSAA 1997 Nebraska High School Boys Basketball State Tournament. Now for today's Class A championship game between the 17-5 Lincoln Northeast Rockets. Here are the lineups. First, the non-starters for Lincoln Northeast. Number 5, Jared Allen. Number 10, Graham Simpson. Number 32, Shane Einsvar. Number 42, Joe Eagler. Number 43, Willie Kraft. Number 44, John Bell. Number 50, Jeff Zimmerman. And now the non-starters for Lincoln East. Number 24, Jeff Martin. Number 30, Edwin Holland. Number 34, Adam Kuhl. Number 44, Sean Hatch. Number 52, Jay Swanson. Number 54, Matt Behrens. And Chad Hansen. And now, here are the starters for Lincoln Northeast. A 6'3 senior, number 3, Derek Engelbart. A 6'1 junior, number 4, David Mercer. A 6' sophomore, number 21, T. Mason. A 5'11 junior, number 22, Amon Helmstadter. And a 6'7 senior, number 45, Mike Hahn. The assistant coaches for the Rockets are Rex Mercer, Pat Getzmeyer, Dan Noble, and Joe Scherr. And the head coach of Lincoln Northeast is Rick Calura. And now, here are the starters for Lincoln East. A 6' junior, number 20, Seth Boynton. A 6'1 senior, number 32, Scott Yost. A 6'8 senior, number 40, Ryan Means. A 6'6 sophomore, number 42, Sean Redditch. And a 6'6 senior, number 50, Derek Hose. The assistant coaches for the Spartans are Chris Arndt, Lee Steinbrook, Sean Highhold, and Joe Sigelmelt. And the head coach of Lincoln East is Ed McFerrin. The Officials for today's championship game are Dan Trout and Kevin Bartlett. And the bench official is Lynn Moeller.
Lincoln East, Lincoln Northeast. One thing to keep in mind about this basketball game. The Rockets will pressure you. They will pressure you, and they will continue to pressure you the entire way down, up and down the floor. Lincoln East last year, their Achilles heel was ball handling in the backcourt. This year, they were able to move one of their forwards, Scott Yost, into the backcourt, as well as move up Seth Boynton from the junior varsity team. And together, those two have been able to stabilize backcourt play for the Lincoln East Spartans. We'll see how mature they have gotten now. As we were said earlier, Northeast defeated East 64-63 earlier in the season. The one thing about that game that was so interesting, Dave Willie, was that not only was Mike Hahn in trouble with four fouls late in the game, but so too was Amon Helmstetter, the two big cogs in this Northeast wheel.
The two big cogs, both juniors, they've carried the Rockets all year long. Helmstetter and Hahn, joined by Mercer, Engelbart, Mason. This is exciting. This is going to be good. East and Northeast, first time in 19 years we've had two Lincoln schools go for it all in Class A.
I'd say about 8,500, 9,000 here in the Sports Center for the Class A championship game between two of the capital city's best. The Rockets got here by beating Lincoln High yesterday. The Spartans upended Columbus. As Hahn turn around in the circle, yes.
That's big if Northeast can establish Hahn inside. East is a lot taller, but if the Rockets can get Hahn going, that'll be big. Now they're gonna run.
Scotty Yost running jump shot does not fall, but T. Mason loses it the other way. And it's taken out of there by the Spartans. And Hay had Sean Redditch running down the floor, but Yost didn't see him. 2-0, Northeast, going for a third straight Class A championship.
Rockets start out man-to-man.
And they'll play man-to-man throughout this game, most certainly. Boynton has it outside the circle, looks inside Ryan Means.
Means got a step on Mike Hahn. Hahn lost track of him. Means got the easy two.
Means has been a force this year for the Spartans, 18.2 points per game in double figures in each of the two tournament wins. Helmstetter skip past T. Mason, thought about it from three. T. Mason, the younger brother of Alton Mason, who was such a star the last two, three seasons for the Rockets. Helmstetter's first try at a three is off. Derek Hose outside the three-point arc. Hose was held without a field goal the last time these two teams played. He averages 12 points a game. Outside, Sean Redditch. Off the front iron, loose ball on the floor. Derek Engelbart has it the other way. No, but the follow-up. Oh, Mon Helmstetter.
Three Rockets getting down the floor that time to follow it up. Helmstetter ended up with the ball and put it back up and in. Rockets by two.
Pace right now favors the defending two-time champions. We're 2 minutes into this first quarter. Class A championship from the State Fairgrounds, the Bob Devaney Sports Center. They look down low for a cutting Scott Yost, and we're going to have our first foul of the game, and I believe Amon Helmstetter will pick up his first.
Helmstetter or Mercer?
Let's find out. The official says Dave Mercer.
Yost got the step on Mercer. Mercer a little late getting to the ball. He picks up the foul. First foul on Mercer, first foul on the Rockets.
He made more contact with his teammate Helmstetter than he did with the Spartan. Redditch to inbound for the blue and white to Scott Yost, guarded by Mercer. Tries to run off the pick, can't do it. Northeast switching up nicely. Seth Boynton between the circles. Works against Helmstetter. Helmstetter knocks it away. Engelbart runs the floor. Two Spartans in tow.
Engelbart thought he was fouled. We've got a whistle and a travel. Travel on Redditch as he headed up the floor. So back to the Rockets it goes.
Sean Redditch, younger brother of former Spartan Jeff Redditch. Spartans making their first appearance in this state championships since 1993, their first appearance in the title game since 1985 when they lost to Omaha Northwest. Engelbart Mason play catch, and now a whistle down low and the first foul called on Ryan Means.
Means held Mike Hahn as Hahn tried to establish position. Spartans start out in a zone, a 2-3 zone. First foul on Means, first foul on the Spartans.
5:23 to go, first period. Helmstetter high lob in, T. Mason three, yes.
Can't give T. Mason that kind of room from behind the arc, he'll burn you. There's that rocket pressure we talked about.
But a nice job by the East Spartans to break the press. Into the front court now. 3 minutes into the championship game, and the Spartans find themselves down five. High lob inside Means. No, but Scott Yost had a tip-in try. That falls short as well. Spartans one for their first five in field goal shooting. Helmstetter, Hahn, out to Mercer, three, no. Rebound to Derek Holmes. They run the floor. Redditch against Rocket defense.
Helmstetter again.
Mason again.
It's going to be a long day for Ed McFerrin Spartans if T. Mason's allowed to spot up like that.
That brings them off their seats here in the Devaney Center. 10-2 Rockets. Rockets on an 8-0 run.
This is on replay. T. Mason, top of the key. One of 2 3-pointers Mason already has in this game. Rockets up 8.
T. Mason was an addition to the starting lineup at about midseason. Rockets have gone with about 3 different starting lineups. Usually that fifth position is the one that's shuttled in and out. And we've got a foul down low against Northeast.
They got him on Helmstetter. He slapped the ball loose a couple of times and come up with some steals already. That time he got some arm. That's Helmstetter's first and the Rockets second.
Northeast will accumulate fouls with that pressure. Helmstetter has had problems staying out of foul trouble this year. And Ryan Means travels. He didn't like the call.
Third turnover for Lincoln East. Make it the 4th turnover for Lincoln East here in the first 4 minutes of this ballgame.
3:50 to go in the first, and the Spartans a little pressure now. Helmstetter fakes the three. T. Mason finds Hahn. Nothing touches the floor until that dribble. But the Spartans get back on defense. Nice job by Lincoln East.
Ed McFerrin's going to have to get somebody on T. Mason. Now a near steal for the Rockets.
And Mercer goes flying into the crowd.
Over
I
the
hope
Lincoln
he's okay.
East bench. Yeah, it looks like he's all right. Hopped right over the Lincoln East bench. And he's not going to get any help over there.
Are we sure Al Mason didn't come back from college?
T. Mason filling it up. He has 9 of the Rockets, 13.
His given name is Altaris, but they just call him T for short. 13-2, Rockets.
T as in three.
The key to the Spartan success in this tournament is they are the ones that get out to the quick starts, but not this time. Turn around, Derek Hose.
Hose has 3 or 4 inches on David Mercer. He ought to be able to do that all day long if they can get him down in the post. Now some pressure from the Spartans.
High lob, Hahn was there.
Northeast doing just about whatever it wants here, and now a near turnover.
But a nice save by Derek Hose. Yost to Boynton. Hahn last year scored 23 in the state championship game, including 18 of the first 20 in the second half against Columbus. Outside Redditch for three.
Spartans now just 2 of 7 from the field.
Mason. T. Mason has 12 points, and all of them coming from beyond 19-9.
4 for 4 from behind the arc for Mason. It's a 14-point lead early.
If he keeps shooting like that, there'll be no nets to cut down after this game. Rockets again, 3 from Helmstetter, too strong. You are seeing championship experience right here.
Big time.
Ed McFerrin has to wonder what's going on here. That time Mercer called with a foul in the backcourt.
Northeast strikes so quickly with their defensive pressure, and then when they can hit threes like T. Mason's hit so far in this ball game, you're in trouble trying to stop it, and the Spartans haven't yet.
Inbound to Redditch, now to Boynton, working against T. Mason, 18-4 Lincoln Northeast. A minute 40 to play, first period. Turnaround move means no. Redditch cleans it up, yes. Back the other way again. Northeast does not take their time. Engelbart, Mercer, back to Engelbart. A minute 17. Helmstetter thought about it from three. Right in the lane, spinning move, but he missed the gimme. Means brings it out of there for the Spartans.
Spartans can get back within 10, but Hose took a walk.
That's the second time he's been called. That's the fifth Spartan turnover. Usually the turnovers by turnovers that Northeast has against their opponents are caused by steals. But not in this case, only two steals so far. Engelbart from Hahn.
Great look by Mike Hahn as Engelbart cut to the hole. Beautiful pass right in stride. Engelbart the two, back to a 14-point lead.
Northeast wants to decide this championship in the first quarter. 40 seconds left. Lob down low, they had numbers. Means can't get the jumper to fall. Helmstetter tips it out of bounds.
Good defense that time by Mike Hahn, as you said. East had numbers, but Hahn kind of just made Ryan Means pull up. Couldn't do anything with the ball. By that time, Hahn got help from the defense.
Pull up jumper Means, no. Yost had his fingers on it, but Helmstetter comes away with it for the Rockets. They run the floor. Hahn! Oh, my goodness.
What an athletic play by Mike Hahn. Off balance, flying through the air, he gets it to fall.
14 seconds left in the half. The Spartans are trying to do too much. Down low, Hahn on the feed. No, Redditch with it with 5 seconds left. Back the other way, Yost with three. He'll lay it up and in at the buzzer. Despite that field goal, the Spartans find themselves down 14 at the end of one. Rockets 22-8.
What a play by Mike Hahn. The feed from Amon Helmstetter climbs up the back of Seth Boynton and still somehow gets the ball in. It's plays like that that has the Rockets up 14.
Jeff Martin into the basketball game for the first time for head coach Ed McFerrin. A look for Means, nearly lost it off his foot to Mark Schlegelmilch. Sean Redditch, they look for Hose. Hose turn around. Yes, the basket counts.
Big basket there for Hose. Posting up Mike Hahn down low on the block. Gets position, puts it on the floor once. And a strong move. Hahn catches him on the arm. Hose goes glass. Chance for a three-point play.
Derek Hose with 4 points. He had three on free throws last time these two teams played. He's got five. Helmstetter into the offensive zone. T. Mason, don't dare him to shoot it from out there. He's already made four. Hahn. He'll go to the line for two.
One thing about Northeast, yeah, they're prone to exploding, as we see Mike Hahn here explode to the hole, draw the foul on Sean Redditch, his first. Northeast can explode, but they're also prone to going into some lulls. They jumped out to a 17-point lead earlier this year on Southeast and lost. They led Hastings by 18 in the fourth quarter and lost. So they may lead by 12 right now, but past history tells you East is certainly not out of this game.
I contend that Northeast is the best team in Class A when they want to be. Mental lapses have been their foil in at least three of their five losses this year. Cut down low. Nice move, Means.
Good cut by Means. Nice pass. Got the ball. Quick release. Up and in. The lead's down to 10.
Helmstetter works against Jeff Martin. Outside to Engelbart. Now to Mercer. Skip pass. Helmstetter. Thought about it from three. Now drives inside. Finds it on. That time he didn't get it to go. Ryan Means may have had something to say about that. Spartans can get it back to single digits here, trailing by 10. Entry pass, Hose. And that's his third miscue handling the basketball.
He has the size advantage on Helmstetter right there, about an 8-inch size advantage. But Helmstetter's quick. And if Hose can't put the ball on the floor, they're going to get some turnovers, and that's what happened right there.
Jeff Zimmerman, with the only full head of hair in the building, or at least on the floor, checks in for Rick Kalura as Mike Hahn will take a breather. T. Mason across the timeline. Spinning move, Helmstetter. Mason. Slapped out of there, and the Spartans come back the other way. Martin, nice move on Helmstetter. Pull-up jumper, no. Everyone crashing the boards. Still loose, and we have a tie-up. Possession arrow to Northeast.
No, I think they're going to charge Northeast with a timeout. I think David Mercer called a timeout when he was down on the floor scrambling for the ball.
Rick Kalura trying to get a clarification. Timeout on the floor, 6:09 to go in the Class A championship, second quarter. Back to action in the Class A title game as you see Means drive inside.
At 6'8", Ryan Means can play inside or outside. That time he uses his quickness to get past Mike Hahn and get inside for the two. Lincoln East now has cut the deficit to 10. They need a couple of defensive stops and then convert on the offensive end. And they're right back in this ballgame.
The Sequoia Spartans host the tallest lineup in Class A. Zimmerman wants to make the entry pass. Can't find anybody, so it's Engelbart for three. Redditch is fouled from behind by Zimmerman.
That's Zimmerman's first foul. And the fourth team foul on the Rockets. Make it the fifth. 5:52 to play here, second quarter.
If you're looking for positives for Lincoln East, they've only committed two fouls here in this first half. And they're also winning the rebounding war as that one's thrown out of bounds. The one battle they're not winning is the one on the scoreboard and the turnovers. That's number 8. And Ed McFerrin, that jacket's going to come off here pretty quick, I'm sure.
Starting to get a little hotter to the collar.
Scott Yost will check in for the Spartans, so too will Seth Boynton at the next whistle. Engelbart fakes the three, brings it out. Mercer lost it. Mercer went one way, the ball went the other.
Ladies and gentlemen, please refrain from throwing any objects onto the playing floor.
We have a few items thrown to the floor from the Northeast side. Quickly removed.
Into the game for Lincoln East, number 20, Seth Boynton.
Seth Boynton checks back in, as well as Scott Yost for the Spartans.
To Redditch. Now Redditch will wait for his teammates to join him. Hose over in the corner. Adam Cool, no. 23-13. It's been that way for just a little bit. Zimmerman up against Derek Hose.
Nice move by Zimmerman. He's a little bigger, a little more physical.
And then Helmstetter steals it away. They are so quick.
Mike Hahn checks back into the lineup. He'll replace Zimmerman. Hahn, a good start. 7 points already for the junior.
5 minutes to go, first half, 23-15, Lincoln Northeast. High lob inside. Mercer jumped tall for it. Or was that Engel? That was Engelbart, excuse me. And heavy, heavy contact.
Engelbart thought he was fouled. We have to have some kind of call here. What are they calling? Officials meet. Engelbart went high, couldn't handle the pass, and got bumped. Technical foul for slapping the backboard. I think they got hosed for slapping the backboard.
So to the line, Amon Helmstetter to shoot the technical. Ed McFerrin comes out to the scorer's table and wants an explanation. He's not happy about that call. Now possession belongs to the Rockets as well.
Ed McFerrin still at the scorer's table. He won't move till he gets an explanation.
If they got him for slapping the backboard, that's a call I have not heard of. I mean, he's anticipating the block shot.
Now they bring the other official in, try to straighten this out.
McFerrin has coached in Lincoln Public Schools for 25 years. This is his second year as head coach. Now
Here's
Rick Calora joins
Here's him. The play again. Hose goes for the block and slaps the backboard. And then he just falls on Engelbart. No words exchanged. Hose just gets up and goes about his business.
He was anticipating the shot and wanting to pin that basketball up against the backboard.
Exactly, and then Engelbart couldn't handle the pass, and the shot was never made.
And that technical foul brings the coat off.
That's right, and it was, in fact, the board shows it now, a technical foul on Derrick Hose.
Hahn, partially spun out of his hands, called for the travel. One thing that Ed McFerrin did not inherit from his college coach, Joe Cipriano, was his intense temper. He could have really blown up there, but he didn't. Spartans trying to break that backcourt press. Andu, Redditch, out to Yost. 26-13. So the Spartans essentially survived that technical foul. Rockets only able to score one when they could have scored as much as four or five.
They got Helmstetter. Helmstetter was sagging back off Boynton. The Rockets playing the man-to-man, but Helmstetter was sagging back off of Boynton, covering the post. And the ball came into the post. Helmstetter reached in. That's his second. Sixth on the Rockets, so that the Spartans will shoot free throws from here on out.
We said Northeast will get into foul trouble from time to time. Here's a Redditch feed, no.
And they either got Mycon or T. Mason for a foul here.
Ryan Means in one motion not only saved the basketball, but fed his teammate Jeff Redditch in the low post. The sophomore, Sean Redditch, 6'6". Redditch had one of the best games I've seen him play in his brief career against Columbus yesterday. 12 points, 5 rebounds, and 4 steals. He also was very effective assisting. Rockets by 11. Helmstetter out to T. Mason. Here we go again. Nope. That's his first miss from three-point range, but John Bell comes out of there with it. Now Bell from three.
What a sequence for Bell. Keeps the ball alive. Then they rotate the ball, reverse the ball against the zone to him, and he drains the three. 14-point lead now for the Rockets.
John Bell was the off-the-bench hero in the last meeting between these two teams with 3 three-pointers. Redditch answers. When Helmstetter and Hahn were on the bench with 4 fouls, it was John Bell who sparked the Northeast rally on January 9. He has it outside the three-point arc. 29-17, Rockets lead by 12. They've led the entire way. Drive and Mercer lost it on the dribble, but somehow gets it to T. Mason. Bell for three, no. Rebound Seth Boynton, and Mercer called for crawling over the back.
Foul on Mercer will be his second. Make it his third. That's big. 3:21 to play here, still in the second quarter. And David Mercer will have to take a seat with his third foul.
And in to replace him, 5'10 senior Graham Spencer. Edwin Holland also checks in for his first action. He replaces Sean Redditch for the East Spartans.
That's the eighth team foul on the Rockets, so Seth Boynton gets a 1-1.
Rockets running again, but that pass, lead pass, way too strong. Just put a little too much over the top. 3:15 to go first half. Rockets going for a third straight Class A championship.
How about John Bell? Rebounds the ball, saves it from going out of bounds. They reverse it to who else? John Bell, he spots up for the three, and Drano. Rockets by 12 here, 3:15 to go in the second.
5 3-pointers made in this game for the Northeast Rockets. They've shot 11 of them. That's not bad percentage, 5 from 11 from beyond 19-9. Nearing the 3-minute mark to play first half, Spartans have trailed this entire game, still trying to establish their offensive rhythm. Yo skip past Boynton for three or two, it doesn't matter, didn't make it. And then Boynton comes in and slaps the hand of Amon Helmstetter.
Kind of a silly foul there by Boynton, his first. Just the fourth on Lincoln East. So they're in good shape as far as that's concerned. Though they trail by 12.
Helmstetter across the timeline. Gets the feed. Scoop layup missed, and he'll go to the line to shoot foul shots.
Strong move by Helmstetter in there among the trees. He's just 5'10", but he goes right up on 6'8", Ryan Means, and 6'6", Derek Hose. Draws the foul on Hose. That's Hose's second. Of course, he had the technical a little while ago for slapping the backboard.
Helmstetter was the understudy to Alton Mason last year. If you remember last year's championship, it was Mason that ran the point. Helmstetter was the off guard. This year, Helmstetter moves into the point guard role, and younger brother T. Mason is the off guard as the first foul shot falls away. To 17, Northeast Rockets.
More pressure.
Deep pass, nearly lost, but Means was able to retrieve it. Ed McFerrin has to be happy from one respect. For the most part, they've been able to handle backcourt pressure. They've made most of their turnovers either in transition or in the offensive zone. Hose up top. Means thought about it from three.
He'll shoot that.
Scott Yost. And a travel on Amon Helmstetter.
Amon Helmstetter went to pass the ball to Graham Svensson, but Svensson wasn't looking and he had to take the walk. Fifth turnover in the game for the Rockets.
2 minutes to go first half. Spartans again, another chance to cut it to single digits. It's been a double digit Rocket lead for quite some time. Means. Fade away just a bit too strong. Helmstetter again. Bounce pass entry for Svensson, but he couldn't get it. But Helmstetter comes back with it. 1:35 to go first half. Svensson off the pick.
Beautiful play there as he got the pick. Wide open for the jumper, and he put it in.
Svensson's first two. 1:15 to go first half. Spartans, Means against Hahn. Yes. Ryan Means has 6. Spartans with 21. Rockets have 32. Under 1 minute to go in the first half. Helmstetter inside for Hahn, kicks it out. Engelbart drives inside. Hanger, no. Tip up, no. Rebound, Means. Spartans with 40 seconds left in the half. Another chance to get within single digits. You get the feeling if they can get over that hump, maybe they can make something out of this. Spartans shooting 39% from the floor. 25 seconds left in the half. That compares to Northeast 44% shooting. Hose. Yost now back to Boynton with 13 seconds left. Ed McFerrin says, get in there, get in there. Long three-point from Means. No, that's not the shot the Spartans wanted to take. Rockets with two, with one. Helmstetter a hanger at the buzzer. No. We've played 16 minutes, and it's been a very fast 16 minutes for Lincoln Northeast. They lead 32-21 at halftime. The Spartans have been betrayed by turnovers, 10 compared to 5 for Northeast. The Rockets, spearheaded by 4-for-4 three-point shooting out of T. Mason to start this game. He's now 4-for-6. The Spartans are going to have to find a way to get some offensive rhythm. And let's find out what Ed McFerrin has on his mind. Let's go to Dave Willing.
All right, John Bishop. Coach, you kind of weathered the storm and you're still in it.
Well, I don't know if we're weathering it yet. We have to get back into it now with some solid play. We're just not reacting real well to their press. They're reaching and getting the ball away from us on the press, and that's causing us some problems.
Good luck second half.
Thank you.
That's Ed McFerrin, Lincoln East coach. His Spartans trail it here at halftime of the Class A State Championship game by 11. Halftime of the Class A state title game. Well, you just saw your Class A All-State team here to talk about it. Dave Ullman, the coach up in North Fork. Coach, you played against several of these players. Talk about them a little bit.
Well, I think it's a coach's dream to have those five kids. Their guards are outstanding. You know, James Perez from North Platte averages about 20 points a game. He's an excellent three-point shooter, penetrates, you know, great passer. And then Cody Levinson from Grand Island is probably as creative a player as there is in the state. You know, he averaged about 22 points and was really hard to stop him. And then I think the post player, Mike Hahn, is probably as good a player as I've seen. He's got great hands. He runs the floor really well, a great rebounder, you know, and gives a really good inside game to Northeast. And then you have two outstanding forwards in Ryan Means from Lincoln East, and he's probably averaging 18 points. 9 or 10 rebounds, and then Mike Muma from Papillion. I mean, they're just outstanding kids, I think, and great basketball players. So you really guys did a nice job of picking that squad.
We'd like to take credit, but the coaches actually did it. Thank you very much for that.
Okay, thank you. Enjoy your talk.
That's Coach Dave Ullman from Norfolk. And again, we're at halftime where Lincoln Northeast leads it by 11.
As we take a look at the team stats, the big one is the bottom one. Turnovers, 10 for Lincoln East compared to 5 for Northeast. Rockets led in scoring by T. Mason with 12. 6 points each for Lincoln East, Ryan Means, and Sean Redditch. Let's go back to Dave Willing.
All righty, John Bishop, thank you very much. Down here courtside with Mike Tucon from Wendy's Restaurants in Grand Island and further west of the state, of course. Tell us a little bit about what the Wendy's Heisman is and how players can apply.
Well, the Wendy's Heisman program was founded to reward high school seniors who excel in academics, community support, as well as athletic achievement. The seniors are actually nominated for the Wendy's Heisman Award by their principals, but with the help of guidance counselors as well as athletic directors, one male and one female is selected from each school across the U.S. This is the fourth year of the Wendy's Heisman program, and I'm proud to say that in each of the past 3 years, there have been between 8,000 and 10,000 nominations.
Amazing.
Thank you.
All right, thank you very much. Mike Tocan from Grand Island, Wendy's from out in the western part of the state. Again, we're at halftime where Northeast leads it by 11.
The Lincoln East Spartan Pep Band playing at halftime is Northeast leading the Spartans 32-21. If you're thinking about three-point shooting, Lincoln Northeast, obviously the dominant team in that category. They've got about a half dozen guys that can throw that rock up there, 5-for-11 from three-point range. Spartans 0-for-3. They're more apt at playing that half-court offense and getting someone down low. They need to establish some offensive rhythm in the second half. We'll be back with the second half of the Class A Championship right after this. Northeast going for a third straight championship, leading by 11 as we near the start of the second half. We don't want you to think that we're ignoring Rick Kalura, but his team just got onto the floor about a minute ago. They took an awful long time in that locker room, and I have a feeling that Coach Kalura, Dave Willey, was saying, guys, we've had leads like this in the second half before this year, and we've blown them. Let's don't blow this one. Keep your head in the game and keep focused.
Absolutely. I'm sure the word Hastings may have come up after they blew that 18-point lead to Hastings in the fourth quarter earlier this year.
And that was at home, too.
Absolutely. He certainly doesn't want his Rockets to get complacent. They haven't won a thing yet. Still 16 minutes of basketball to go, even though they still have that 11-point lead.
Rockets have dictated their will so far in this game. Second half of play. It's Helmstetter working against Yost. A look inside for Hahn. Boynton was standing right in front of him. Good defense by Boynton, but Hahn gets it back and gets another crack.
Looked like Rick Kalura designed to play out of the timeout there to start this half to go inside to Mike Hahn. They tried it twice, and the second time, Hahn got it in.
Hahn with 9 points and Engelbart with a steal. Now back to Engelbart, but he has to pull it back. Redditch was back quickly on defense. T. Mason to Dave Mercer. Engelbart in the right corner. 7:15 to go third quarter. Rick Kalura calling for more motion.
Spartans in a man-to-man here to start the second half.
Outside, Helmstetter. That would have been a very long three. Instead, to Hahn. Triple pumps. Oh, yes.
Wow, what a play by Hahn. A quick spin move, a pump fake, then a strong move to get it up and in, even though he was fouled. And just like that, the lead's back to 15.
And Mike Hahn is only a junior.
The good fake to his left got Means going that way. Then he spun to the right, put the ball on the floor. The pump fake got Means up in the air, draws the foul, gets the basket. Second foul for Means. 16-point lead now for the Rockets.
Hahn in double figures with 11. And Hose lost it off his foot. Derek Hose's problems continue. And now a foul on Lincoln East. I believe that's Scott Yost.
Just the first on Yost. Second already, though, on the Spartans here in the second half.
With a 16-point lead, this game can get out of hand very quick. And any chance for Lincoln East could be just burned away. Three out of Engelbart, no. Rebound to Yost, and Engelbart trying to follow the shot. Maybe got Yost in the face.
Engelbart doesn't think so, but his opinion doesn't matter. Just the first on Engelbart, just the first on the Rockets in the second half. Full-court pressure again by Northeast.
The difference in this game between the last time these teams met was that Northeast has not been in as much foul trouble, and also they got off to the quick start, which allowed them not to play quite as aggressive.
Just like that, though, Amon Helmstetter picks up his third.
Helmstetter's only got 4 points, but when you figure in that he's got 7 boards, 10 assists, you know what kind of importance he has to this basketball team. And getting him off the floor has to be a priority for East, outside of scoring points. Boynton draws double coverage, and Helmstetter knocks it away. And then Boynton has no choice but to foul him.
Amon Helmstetter with the quick hands here, even in foul trouble, still with the defensive pressure. Nice pump fake. And then Boynton just kind of pushes him aside to make sure he doesn't get the layup. Try to circle shot. 16-point lead still for Northeast. Second foul on Boynton, third on East in the half.
Shooting two shots.
Helmstetter shoots a very flat free throw. Not a whole lot of arch.
He's 3 of 5 from the line in this game, 5 points. Make that 3 out of 6.
Very little margin for error on a free throw that flat.
Spartans trying to muster some offense. Inside Hose, turn around, yes.
That ends about a 3-minute and 10-second drought for East.
First points of the second half. Spartans down 15. Hose with 7 to lead Spartan scoring.
Hahn has position on Means. He's got it again.
And he has the basketball. What will he do with it? Tried to find T. Mason. And the Spartans get it. As I believe Hahn either stepped on the baseline or they lost the ball out of bounds. Another near steal, and Mercer is called with his 4th.
Northeast guards starting to pile up some fouls. That's 4 on Mercer. We still have 5:29 to play in the third quarter. He's going to take a seat. We might not see him for a while. He'll be replaced by Graham Svensson.
Spartans down 15. They have trailed right from the get-go. Redditch, hanger, yes. Nice job of body control there by Sean Redditch. He has 8 points. Lincoln East down 13 now. Svensson, Engelbart, Helmstetter for 3.
They have to get out to deny that. He'll shoot that all day long. It's back to a 16-point lead.
8 points for Helmstetter. Nearly takes the foul and then knocked away by Svensson to Mike Hahn to Helmstetter. And then a reach-in foul from behind on Scott Yost. And for Yost, I believe that's his 2nd.
Four team fouls now on East here in the half. Rockets with the ball out of bounds underneath. Chance to go up 18 or 19 if they hit a 3.
Yost tipped away the pass. It'll go out of bounds in front of his head coach. But at least it disrupted the offense somewhat. And Northeast will have to inbound from the backcourt. 14 Spartan turnovers, 8 steals by Northeast. They lead by 16 to match their biggest lead and then lost off the foot. Hose falling to the ground, tries to throw a lead pass, and T. Mason gathers it up.
Too much quickness for Northeast.
Back the other way, Hahn in the lane, gives it up for Engelbart, but he walked. -45 as Yost saves the basketball from hitting my head. And now a foul on T. Mason. That's his first
foul. First foul on Mason. 4 now on Northeast. We've got a timeout on the floor.
With 4 minutes and 15 seconds to play in the third period, the Rockets still in command by 16. Amon Helmstetter could be on his way to a triple-double.
Scott Yost doesn't have the quickness to stop his penetration, so he has to give him the 3. Helmstetter spots up there and drills it.
Helmstetter, 10 assists, 7 rebounds, 8 points. 41-25. Lincoln East trails by 16.
They're leaving Boynton wide open at the top of the key. He could step in and hit a jumper.
And then they lose it out of bounds. Northeast is not allowing penetration underneath.
And Ed McFerrin's telling Boynton right now, shoot the ball. Step in and shoot the ball. He's got the top of the key three-pointer wide open to him.
Boynton is not this major scoring threat, averaging under 5 points a game. But if they're going to give it to him, he may have to start chucking it to change up Northeast defensive philosophy. Helmstetter bounce pass down low, and a foul on Shaw on Redditch.
Great look down low from Helmstetter to T. Mason. Beautiful bounce pass. Redditch comes over, looked pretty clean. He can't believe it.
Rick Calura was calling for a goaltend as well, which would have given him the basket and a chance for a three-point play. But instead, it's just the foul and two foul shots.
The Northeast students kind of jump up and down, a la the Dukies.
And it was some cause of some controversy yesterday in that game against Columbus. Their jumping up and down was so severe, it broke a plank out from the bleachers amid several warnings not to do that. Bounce pass low, still Northeast ball with 3:21 to go third period, and the Rockets with their biggest lead, 17.
The Rockets seem like they're poised to turn this one into a blowout.
Some East fans might be saying, isn't it already a blowout? Turn around, move Hahn. It's not the same second half he enjoyed last year during the state championship game, but with his team leading by 19, you see why. Nice lob down low, but Hose, his timing was just a bit off. Helmstetter for three. And a foul over the back on Hahn.
Hahn a little late getting to the spot there. That'll be three on Mike Hahn. That's the fifth team foul, and we have a timeout on the floor.
With 2 minutes and 54 seconds to play in the third period, the Rockets leading 44 to 25. And those turnovers are really hurting Lincoln East, 16 of them.
Spartans right now, 16 turnovers. You combine that with just 41% shooting from the field. Then you look at the other side of the ledger, Northeast shooting 49% from the field and committing just 7 turnovers. So Northeast winning the stat sheet, winning the scoreboard, winning all over the place. It's 44 to 25 here right now. Ed McFerrin calls a timeout here. He knows this one is starting to get away.
We've said before that Lincoln Northeast, as we take a look at what Hahn can do to you, we've said before in this broadcast that Northeast is probably the best team in the state when they want to be. And what I mean by that is when they have their head in the game for an entire 32 minutes. The times that they have lost leads is when they've lost focus. The Rockets have lost 5 times, but their record matched last year's coming into this state tournament. And sure enough, they went on to be state champions. Just because you're not the number one seed doesn't mean you're not the number one team.
Those seeds are by record only.
Pointing across, double covered. Now here's Hose driving, yes.
Derek Hose
with 9 points, which is better than the last time these two teams played, but his teammates had not been able to pick up the offensive slack. Now 44-27 Rockets. And Rick Calura still coaching out there, says movement, movement. The Rockets love to move that ball around.
Redditch that time fouled Hahn. For Redditch, his 3rd. For East, their 6th.
And for the Spartans, that's the first one in foul trouble with 3. We have 2:17 left in the third period of this Class A championship. Rockets playing in their 4th consecutive state championship game. They've won 2 straight. Skip pass Helmstetter to T. Mason. Mason was open for a 2nd, but then Means covered. Helmstetter for 3, no. Then Mason jumping over the top of Ryan Means draws the foul.
Just the 2nd on T. Mason. That's the 6th foul, team foul on Northeast. T. Mason right there slapping for the rebound.
Spartans again. 44 to 27. Redditch to Hose. Hose, turnaround move, basket too strong. T. Mason with the rebound. They're going to get him called for the travel.
Rick
but the Rockets can't be happy because Scott Yost tripped him.
He tripped him and then kind of pushed him down. Rick Kalura whistles at the officials. He can't believe it. Watch this. Helmstetter right there. Yost sticks his foot out. Helmstetter trips over it. And Helmstetter gets called for the walk.
Tough call, but for Spartan faithful, they will take it. Nearing a minute to go in the third, and a three on the way, and Boynton finally hits.
It's been there all afternoon. They haven't guarded Boynton at all out top, daring him to shoot it. That time he did, and he made it. They've cut the lead to 14.
Engelbart, 50 seconds left in the quarter. Graham Svensson. Engelbart drives inside, pump fakes, has to get it back out to T. Mason. Now to Helmstetter, playing with three fouls. Drives, free throw line jumper, no. Rebound, Engelbart off the glass, but a charge.
Engelbart lowered the shoulder, Yost stood his ground, and drew the charge on Engelbart. For Engelbart, his second foul. That's the seventh team foul, but because it's a player control foul, no free throws.
Spartans have the last 25 seconds to themselves, maybe. Depends on how well they can break this pressure. Again, the Spartans succeed. Then almost lost it in the front court. 14 seconds left, 13 seconds left. Boynton with the basketball, 10 seconds, 9 seconds left to play, third period. Lincoln East down 14, 6 seconds, trying to find an open man. Rockets coming out in defense, hanging jump shot, Yost! It wasn't pretty, but it worked. That draws the Spartans within 12 to start the fourth. Spartans play a game of hot potato. You take it. No, you take it. No, I've got it.
I doubt that's how Ed McFerrin has it in the playbook, but it works. It beats the buzzer and draws the Spartans back with a 12 to start the fourth.
Everybody on their feet, at least in the first couple of sections. Redditch. It's now a 10-point Spartan deficit. But quickly the other way, Mercer. No, Hahn there to retrieve. Whistle, contact, foul.
On Redditch. They got Redditch on the foul. Big basket on the other end. Let's see if we can see the foul. No foul there. Redditch coming over the top on Mike Hahn. Nickel dimer there. Not a whole lot of contact, but it sends him on Helmstetter to the line for a 1-1.
Helmstetter to the line, 8 points.
Amon Helmstetter, 9 points, 11 assists, 8 rebounds. He's a point and 2 rebounds away from a triple-double. David Mercer's back out on the floor for the Rockets. He has 4 fouls.
Ed Holland has it for Lincoln East. Now to Seth Boynton. 12-point Rocket lead. Boynton brings it across. Holland up top, hanging jump shot off balance, partially because he was fouled.
Engelbart now has 3. So if you look, you count up the fouls for Northeast, Engelbart has 3, Mercer 4, Helmstetter 3, Mike Hahn 3. 4 of your 5 starters, if you're a Northeast fan, have at least 3, and David Mercer has 4. So we've got a long way to go.
We do. Derek Engelbart checks out. Shane Einspar, 6'4" senior forward, is in. We are a couple fouls away from changing the complexion of this game entirely.
The key is Helmstetter. If he can avoid getting his fourth, Northeast is a completely different team when Helmstetter's on the court.
Holland can't get it, but Yost there for the put back, the foul, and the count.
What a play by Yost. Mercer can't believe it. He thought Yost climbed his back to get the rebound. And he might have a legitimate complaint, but Yost gets the rebound. Then he's hooked down on the play. The foul for Northeast on number 32, Shane Einspar, his first. 3-point play opportunity. They can cut it to 9.
Rolls in and out. Hahn with the big rebound. 36 points for East. Rockets have 46. Yost has 8 in the basketball game. Now you see a little bit more spring in the step of Northeast.
A little more urgency.
They realize that they could have put this game away a long time ago, and they didn't. Helmstetter against Yost. Helmstetter drives baseline. Three-pointer. No. Rebound, Einspar.
Fouled by Yost. No. Who'd they get?
They got Ryan Means, his third.
If you're an East fan, 3 for Means, 4 for Redditch.
Shane Einspar. Six minutes and 42 seconds to go in the state championship of Class A, the 87th. Turnaround move. Yes, Ryan Means with 8.
Forgive me if I'm wrong, but I believe this is the first time East has been within 10 since the first quarter and early on in the first quarter.
You are correct. It's been a while, and now a foul on Yost.
Yost can't stop Helmstetter. He's too quick. That's 3 on Yost. Helmstetter a 1-1. Northeast needs to convert on these foul shots.
Ed McFerrin, Spartans not out of this one yet. Helmstetter 6 of 9 from the free throw line, 11 points to match 11 assists. Rolls in and out, but Hahn comes down with it. You said Amon Helmstetter makes a difference, and he's on the floor. I'll say the same for Mike Hahn. Now it is back to double digits, 49 to 38. 6 minutes to go in the Class A title game. Hose drives inside, yes.
Great move by Hose. Bell can't handle it.
11 points for Hose. 9-point Rocket lead. Helmstetter. So fluid. Now Yost is trapped and he's smart. Calls a timeout. With 5 minutes and 32 seconds left, Lincoln East has 1 timeout left. They trail by 11. Derek Holmes, 2 of his 11.
We talk about the great size for Lincoln East, and they have the 6 players over 6'6", but those guys can handle the ball. Redditch, Means, Hose, as we just saw. Lincoln East now shooting 51% from the field, but they still trail by 11.
In part because of the 16 turnovers, yet the turnovers have come down here in the second half for Lincoln East. Edwin Holland outside Hose, and it kicked off his foot. If this were a VCR, Derek Hose would hit the rewind button and say, let's start this over again, or put in a new tape or something. He's had 11 points, but he's turned the ball over 6 times. Helmstetter and Yost collide. No call. Helmstetter again.
That's a mismatch. Yost cannot handle Helmstetter. Second time in a row now. Helmstetter's taken into the hole.
53-40. A 13-point Rocket lead. Now Northeast starting to come out on the perimeter a little. Boynton has an open three. Hahn saves it to Engelbart.
Helmstetter was wide open down here at the other end, but they didn't see him.
And he's calling for the ball now. Baseline draws the foul on Ryan Means.
That's four on Means. So both he and Redditch, four fouls apiece.
And Redditch is about to come back in.
Don't have any choice at this point. 4:22 to play. You're down 13. And the other guy's at the line shooting two.
It's do or die if you're a Spartan. You're 4 minutes and 22 seconds away from history if you're a Rocket.
Helmstetter now 15 points to go along with those 8 rebounds and 11 assists.
Spartans now trail 14. Yost into the offensive zone. To Hose, fouled over the back. Helmstetter.
That's four on Helmstetter. So Mercer and Helmstetter both with four for the Rockets. Redditch and Means with four for the Spartans. That's 10 team fouls on the Rockets, so Lincoln East will have the double bonus for the last 4 minutes and 11 seconds of at least regulation. Derek Hose at the line. They're shooting, though, just 3 of 7 from the line are the Spartans, 43%. They have to improve on that here down the stretch.
Derek Hose with 12 points. Helmstetter and his Rocket teammates win a run. Hahn feed down low, no. Rebound to Ryan Means. Spartans trail by 13 here. We're under 4 minutes to play in the state title game. Redditch, spin around move.
Out of control.
And Ed McFerrin collapses and has nothing but a smile. I think that look says it all. They wanted the call, didn't get it. Now it's the Spartans forced to press in the backcourt. And it's Helmstetter. Oh, nice feed to Hahn.
The Spartans have no one that can keep up with Amon Helmstetter.
Loose ball, Boynton saves it, but unfortunately right to Mike Hahn. That doesn't discredit the great athleticism by Seth Boynton. As it kicks off of his foot. Amon Helmstetter with 12 assists in this game, 16 points, 9 rebounds. One more and he has a triple-double. 3:22 to go in the game and the Rockets can smell a championship. Amon Helmstetter.
That's assist number 12 for Helmstetter as he sets up his big guy, Mike Hahn. That gave the Rockets a 15-point lead. And as you said before the break, they can smell a three-peat.
The rest of Class A is going to be asking if Helmstetter and Hahn can leave early for college. They're both juniors. They'll be back next year. Rockets with a basketball and a 15-point lead. Helmstetter to Hahn. If I'm repeating myself, I apologize.
Helmstetter's gone. Helmstetter's going to watch the last 3 minutes and 1 second of this game from the bench. He just fouled out.
But when it fouls out, Dave, it's at least with a 17-point lead.
He's telling his teammates, hold the fort. We're this close. We're this close. Graham Svensson will replace him. And he gives Svensson some encouragement.
Look at him jawing with his teammates. He won't get his triple-double, but what the hey.
One rebound away from a triple-double. 16 points, 9 rebounds, 13 assists for Amon Helmstetter.
And Hose doesn't convert on the first in. Just not getting the lucky bounce. 17-point lead. Here's T. Mason. Loose on the floor. Tie up, possession arrow northeast.
Let's see if Rick Kalura tells his team to maybe run some clock here. 2:50 to play. Settle down, he told him. 17-point lead. No reason to be in a hurry. Rocket fans think it's in the bag.
They have good reason to think that way. T. Mason.
East can foul, but they already have 10 team fouls for the half, so it'll be two shots.
Either way, they're going to have to stop the clock here. Shot doesn't count, but we do have a foul. The pink sweatshirt, the pink sweater, good luck again.
It'll be 10-0 if this one continues like it's going. It started at districts last year, just by accident. Rick Kalura says he wears coat and tie when the Rockets play in Lincoln, and he wears a sweater when they leave town. Well, they had to play the districts in Omaha last year, which means they wear a sweater. He wore that sweater in the first game of the districts last year. The Rockets installed a brand new offense. They went out and lit it up. Come back for the district title against Millard South, a team that they'd lost to by 17 during the regular season. He wore the sweater again. They won the game by 18, and the rest is history.
18-point lead. Redditch to Boynton. And the three-peat chant emits from the Northeast student section. For the Spartans, as we have a foul on T. Mason and head coach Ed McFerrin, this has been a season called, you could probably say, return to glory. The Spartans were the poor sister of Lincoln's Class A four basketball teams since 1993. Lincoln High, Lincoln Southeast, Lincoln Northeast had all enjoyed their share of success, making it to state, the Rockets with the state titles, and Lincoln East was left to sit on the sidelines. But this year, Ed McFerrin, in only his second year as head coach, his 25th in Lincoln Public Schools, brought his team back. Redditch for three. Means. And a foul underneath. And Mercer will shoot free throws.
Looks like they got Scott Yost on a push. And Yost is gone. Five on Yost.
Scott Yost playing in his last high school basketball game. Finishes with 8 points, 5 assists, 3 rebounds. It was Scott Yost who at midseason, after Lincoln East beat Lincoln Southeast, predicted on radio that his school would be in the state tournament. They had just cleared the 500 mark at that point.
That's guts.
He was right.
Maybe next year. Maybe next year.
Mason gets the rebound. He is the future.
And you talk about the Rockets' future. Mercer's back. T. Mason's back. Helmstetter's back. Hahn's back. Bell's back. The beat goes on.
For Lincoln East, they'll get Seth Boynton, Ed Holland, Adam Kuhl, who's been a big player off the bench this year. Sean Redditch is only a sophomore. They lose Derek Hose. Ryan Means will graduate. Mark Slegamilch will graduate. So they lose some key players. But in the hands of a head coach who is well-respected and well-liked by his players, don't count the Spartans out next year.
Graham Svensson missed that free throw, and Rick Kalura gave him an earful.
Svensson with 3 points. 61-42, you see the clock.
If you watch Rick Kalura on the sideline, you'd think you're in a two-point game in overtime.
Slegamilch. Derek Hose. And two Northeast Rockets are on the floor and dazed. Mercer and Hahn, now they're back up.
Minute 30 to play here. Northeast still by 17, 61-44. East with some full court pressure.
Under 90 seconds to play. Hahn fouled underneath. Mike Hahn with 20 points last year in the championship, scored 23. He's 9 of 13 from the floor. He's got 9 rebounds.
Another solid performance by Hahn. He's really turning into a big game player.
He started as a sophomore last year, and you could see him getting better with each passing game. And by the end of the year, he was considered the dominant post player in the state. Now as a junior, with more teams keying on him, he still is the dominant post player in the state.
And with Amon Helmstetter out there and T. Mason at the guards, and even David Mercer, Derek Engelbart, they're all enough of an offensive threat that you can't double down on Hahn because somebody else will beat you.
And a 5-second call. Ed McFerrin can only stand and watch the final 71 seconds burn away.
19 turnovers now for East.
Mason to Engelbart, playing in his last game at Lincoln Northeast.
1 minute left in the game.
And the cheers get louder. Redditch.
We're witnessing history.
A foul in the backcourt. Taking a look at teams who have won the most consecutive titles, you go back to Clearwater between 84 and 87. Fall City Sacred Heart from 88 to 91 won four. That dominant juggernaut known as Wahoo from 88 to 91 won four. Lincoln Bethany, a school which no longer exists, won 3 state titles in a row from 36 to 38. Goner won 3 state titles in a row from 27 to 29. And Hardy won 3 straight titles from 1917 to 1919. In 45.3 seconds, you will be able to add to the list Lincoln Northeast, 1995-1997.
And maybe beyond.
There is a very strong possibility. 87 years of Class A basketball in the state tournament. And no Class A team had ever won 3 in a row.
Rick Kalura just gave the thumbs up to all of the Northeast administrators sporting the pink sweaters. He just pointed to his pink sweater, held it out, gave the thumbs up to all the other guys. What a moment.
And the free throw line for Lincoln Northeast, number 25, Mike Hahn. shots.
Jeff Zimmerman back in for the Rockets as Hahn leaves this game. A big hug from Amon Helmstetter. They'll get a chance to do that again next year. A game effort by the Spartans, but the Rockets were just too much.
Too many horses.
Slegamilch. Rebound to Joe Fagler, playing in his last game. He's been off the bench for the last 3 years. He'll shoot a three. Jeff Martin. And a foul with 17.4 seconds left. Shane Einspar to shoot foul shots. We should mention that there's some new players in there for the Spartans. Jay Swanson and Matt Behrens. Haven't had a chance to call their names. They're in there. I believe I see Sean Hatch out there on the floor. Two years ago, he escaped from the shadows of a legendary predecessor by the name of Ed Johnson. Last year, he repeated. And in 1997, Rick Calora and the Northeast Rockets have permanently etched their names in Class A history. Rockets champions again. We'll meet Lincoln East and Lincoln Northeast after this. Rockets cut down the nets for a third straight year, but first, let's meet the Spartans.
Number 30, Edwin Holland. Number 34, Adam Kuhl. Number 44, Sean Hatch. Number 52, Jay Swanson. Number 54, Matt Behrens. Number 20, Seth Boynton. Number 32, Scott Yost. Number 40, Ryan Means.
Go by Mercer!
Number 42, Sean Redditch. And number 50, Derek Hose. Now, all of you are welcome to receive the runner-up trophy for your school. Congratulations, Lincoln East High School, Class A, state runners-up. now to the champions, first coach Rick Kalura. We have a special award for you. Now, coach, hand out the gold medals to your championship team members. We'll introduce them one by one. Number five, Jared Allen. Number 10, Graham Simpson. Number 32, Shane Einsfar. Number 42, Joe Egler. Number 43, Willie Kraft. Number 44, John Bell. Number 50, Jeff Zimmerman. Number 3, Derek Engelbart. Number 4, David Mercer. Number 21, T. Mason. Number 22, Amon Helmstetter. And number 45, Mike Hahn. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1997 Nebraska Class A High School Basketball Champion is Lincoln Northeast High School. Congratulations, players and coaches.
'66-48, Lincoln Northeast, a third straight state championship. With me, head coach Ed McFerrin for Lincoln East. And Coach McFerrin, you take away the first quarter, and maybe this is a better game for you.
Well, I thought they came out and played awfully well. I thought T. Mason hit three threes on us. It really hurt. We thought that was out of our zone, but as we looked at it, it was probably out of our man. And we just switched and made some bad situations, and he just capitalized on them, and that's a sign of a great team. I can't take say enough about how well Northeast played. They great speed and quickness. They ran the press well and got us off balance, and there was not a whole lot we could do about it.
Down as much as you were at halftime, what kinds of things did you want to do coming into the second half?
Well, we wanted to pound the ball inside to our centers, but they countered by sagging off the point guard. And all year long, our point guard has been running our offense and not looking for the shot. He's a good shooter, but this year that was his job role, and he didn't feel comfortable shooting the ball. So he stepped up and hit one there, and would have been nice to hit about 5 or 10, but didn't work out that way.
Last year, the Achilles heel of this team was not being able to handle backcourt pressure. This year, you did a little bit better. You had Seth Boynton move into that role, Scott Yost move into that role. Most of the turnovers of this game, though, seem to happen in the front court.
Oh, yeah, I think I can't say enough about the play of Seth Boynton has done for us this year as far as handling the press. There's only been one or two times that we've lost, had a bad situation or a bad turnover first half or in the back court. So, yeah, we solved that problem with Seth, and I'm still pleased with his efforts and what he's done for us. So we'll be back next year.
Coach McFerrin, it was nice to see Spartan Blue back in the tournament, first time in 4 years. Good luck on next year.
Thank you. We'll be here.
Ed McFerrin. A man who once played college basketball right here in Lincoln. Losing today to Lincoln Northeast, but no shame in that. Stats, field goal percentage pretty much even. The turnovers, the big difference in the game. 19 turnovers for the Spartans to 9 for Lincoln Northeast. Individually, for Lincoln Northeast, they were led by Mike Hahn with 22 points. Amon Helmstetter, we've dictated his stories. He tried to make a triple-double. 16 points, 13 assists, 9 rebounds for Helmstetter as he fouled out with about 2 minutes to go. And T. Mason scored 13 as he scored the first 12 points of three-pointers in this basketball game and came out very strong in that first period. For Lincoln East, Derek Hose with 15 points, had some problems holding onto the basketball, had a couple of travels and a double dribble called against him. It's a game I'm sure he'd like to have back. He did end up with 15 points, though, as he finishes his career with Lincoln East. Sean Redditch, he'll be back next year. He's only a sophomore this year. He has 12 points, and he's going to be one of those big players next year as the Lincoln East Spartans try to make it back here to state. Final score, Lincoln Northeast 66 and Lincoln East 48. As the Rockets win a third straight state championship, Rick Kalura, watching him during all the post-game festivities before the introductions of Rena like he did. It's like he was a kid in a candy store, shaking hands, slapping backs. This is the most excited I've ever seen Rick Kalura after winning a state title. I think he senses the kind of history that winning this state championship for a third year in a row really means, not only to himself, but to his program. Northeast, arguably one of the most successful programs of all time. In fact, the most successful Class A program of the second half century. Lincoln High won a majority of their 14 state titles before World War II, but post-World War II, Lincoln Northeast, by the way, which was born, a school born in 1941, has won 11 championships in their 33 years at state. One-third of the time they've come to the state tournament, they've walked away carrying the championship hardware. It's been a fantastic run for Lincoln Northeast, and the scary thing is most of the key players are back next year. We've talked about Hahn and Helmstetter, John Bell. They're coming back next year. It could be four in a row. This could be a streak that lasts at least one more year. Let's go back now to meet the state champions for a third year in a row. Here's Dave Willey.
All right, John Bishop, thank you very much. As you say, three in a row for Lincoln Northeast. Here with Rick Kalura. How's it feel to win three in a row?
Just as exciting as the first one. This is a great feeling. It's just hard to duplicate, hard to replicate. I'm very happy for our kids and very grateful for my coaching staff.
Coming into this game, had you reflected at all about what it would be to be the first ever Class A team to do three in a row?
No, really, I'd heard that time to time, and really it hadn't been mentioned throughout the season. I guess when you had five losses and three in a row at one point in time, no one's talking about three-peat, and we weren't either. I wanted it so bad for these kids. The pressure was not there for the three-peat. The pressure was to take a team to state to win it like I thought they could, and we had our rough ups and downs this year, but the end result's what counts the most.
Talk about the sweater a little bit. 10-0 now.
Well, the thing's going to get a washing and it'll get put back up in mothballs, but I'm afraid next district's next year it's going to come back out.
Today your defense really came out and set the tone early on. I think East ended up with 19 or 20 turnovers for the game, and I thought that was the difference.
Well, we said the difference would be the boards, and we had to at least hold our own on the boards, and our defense dictated a lot of the tempo because we put on such great pressure, and I think that's been a constant throughout the last 7-8 games, is that our defense has really stepped up. We've gone to a little bit quicker lineup, and T. Mason, Amon Helmstetter, David Mercer, that's three pretty quick kids on the front court.
You just mentioned T. Mason, 4 three-pointers early on that really put some space between you guys and East.
Well, I thought that was the difference in the game. We got a little bit of lead there early on, and then we were able just to hold them off and gradually increase that lead, and sooner or later we got some fast break layups and the full court game was created. So yeah, the three-pointers early on by T in particular, but all those three-pointers really make a difference.
You built the big lead early, but East just kind of hung around. You just couldn't seem to shake them.
Well, we knew that would be the case. They're well coached. Ed McFerrin does a great job, and they're in a state championship game. They're not going to fold, and they competed very hard. They couldn't get some of their shots to drop, and and they did an awfully good job of going to the boards. Fortunately, we had that little lead early, and it made the difference in the game.
Congratulations on making history.
Thank you very much.
That's Coach Rick Kalura of the Lincoln Northeast Rockets, his Rockets winning an unprecedented third straight state championship. Come on in, Derek Engelbart, in Class A. Joining us now, Derek Engelbart, one of the guards, a senior. This has to be sweet.
Oh, there's no better way to go out. This is unbelievable. I can't even explain it to go out like this. Three in a row making history. It's just unbelievable.
All righty. Congratulations again, and good luck from here on out.
Thanks a lot.
That's Derek Engelbart. Coming in now, T. Mason, maybe the difference maker. Coach Rick Kalura said he was the key to the game early on. Four threes. I mean, you really, really set the tone for your team.
Yeah, I was just trying to shoot well. I came out to a good start, and they kept giving the ball, so I was shooting.
Yeah. Defensively, you guys also seemed to step it up, and that really caused the Spartans a lot of problems.
Yeah, Coach Kalura told us the defense is the key to the game, and play well, you know, play good, hard defense, and offense will come along by itself.
Congratulations, T. Mason.
All right, thank you.
T. Mason, guard on this Lincoln Northeast Rocket team. There's one of his threes right there coming on in now. Junior Mike Hahn, a big game, 20 points, 9 rebounds.
First of all, I got to say praise God. I mean, I've been praying all week, and I know he was with me, and I know he's with this team.
Talk a little bit about your game inside. It seemed T. Mason, with the threes, was really opening things up for you.
Well, I was happy for him. You know, we all work hard all year. It's just his day to shine today, I guess. And he was hitting all of his shots. Really opened me up inside. I was able to get some more points, too.
What's this mean to you?
Well, I don't think anything could have topped last year. But since we got a three-peat, I guess it's the only thing that could have topped last year. And it's just the greatest feeling in the world.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
While I've got you here, let me ask you this. Now, four of the five starters are coming back next year. Now, the obvious thing is you've done three. You've got most of the team coming back. What about four?
Well, Coach Kerr is a great coach. You know, he gets us ready to play for districts and state. You know, we have some ups and downs during the season, but you know, don't ever count Northeast out because he's always got us prepared to play.
No prediction?
Smart money's on us.
All right, thank you, Mike Hahn.
Thanks.
That's Mike Hahn, the Lincoln Northeast senior or junior center rather. Big day today. Here comes Amon Helmstetter. Let's go over these stats: 15 points, 13 assists, 9 rebounds. Just a huge day.
You know, I just got to compliment my team. You know, I got a great group of people around me to make my job easier, you know, and a great coaching staff, you know, just the experience there, just know what we're doing, to know everybody what they got to do and stuff.
Today it looked like the defensive matchups that East put on you were really to your benefit. It looked like you were able to take them off the drive.
You know, with the experience with the coaching staff, you know, they know what we got to do, and you know, they scouted East real well, and then we had time to work on them. You know, we worked on every team throughout, you know, each game, you know, and the coaching staff, they just do a real good job, so we know what we have to do to get in to win the game, you know.
How sweet is it to hold that again?
It feels great, you know, just the chance, you know, we did something that no other school has ever done in Nebraska history, and it, I mean, it just feels a tremendous pleasure.
I just asked Mike about four. What do you think about four?
You know, I think it's in our reach. I think we're going to do it. No, then we're gonna get it in one next year too.
All righty, congratulations.
All right, thanks.
All right, that's Amon Helmstetter. We're bringing in now number 32. This is Shane Einspar. He's got part of the net. Hey, a bunch of seniors coming in. Graham Svensson joins us. Jeff Zimmerman joins us. Willie Kraft joins us. Everybody, what's it like for you guys now, one at a time, to win three in a row?
Well, made history. So it's really nice, of course. It's a big thrill. I wanted, as seniors, it's a big goal ever since like seventh grade to win state as a senior. So it's a real big goal, big accomplishment.
How important is it to you guys to go out as champs?
Well, I don't know. we pretty much, you know, we work hard as we can every time, you know. And maybe all of us, you know, don't play, you know, a whole lot. But we go out those other five stars and we make them better. So I think, you know, we just did a real nice job.
Now, during the season, talk to Jeff here real quick. During the season, you guys had some ups and downs. I mean, there was a stretch there where winning a game was more of a goal than maybe even a three-peat. What were you guys thinking? I mean, was the three-peat still in the back of your mind?
Of course it was, but we just want to get our things going and get our role playing straight, so it was always there.
How'd you guys get it turned around?
Probably the scout team and the starters. I mean, we made them better. I mean, we challenged them every day, so that's about how we did it.
Let's talk to Mr. Willie Kraft here. Don't get a lot of playing time, but like he said, talking about in practice. How important is it for you, a guy who maybe behind the scenes doesn't get a lot of the publicity, for you to win a state championship like this?
Oh, it don't get no better than this, you know. That's why we're here, to win this. The individual stuff isn't important. It's the state championship.
What do you do in practice to try to make these guys better?
This past week before districts and state, simulate the team, like Omaha North. We spent all week as Omaha North, and each guy of the scout teams assigned a person, Omaha North starter, and he just, like, the coaches scout their strengths and weaknesses, and you're supposed to try to play like that pretty much.
Well, it certainly worked. Congratulations. And last but certainly not least, number 42, Joe Fegler. Joe, what's this like for you?
Well, this is great going out.